Hello everybody, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 30-minute mission Spinatio Ninja Type, and I have the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So this is the basic version of the model kit, and it's pretty lanky. I do like the clear visor, and it even has, like, eyes, cameras in there. So that's nice. It has a buttload of articulation. It's very, very nimble. It does have polycap ball joints in the chest and the waist, which I'm not a big fan of, but they work. And I do like the hinge they put in the 30-minute mission, which lets the legs go forward even more. I am noticing that the hips start to separate a little bit if you move too much, but not a huge deal. Yeah, it's a very articulate kit, as it should be for a ninja type. Now, it does have extra hands. You got the holding ones here. There's also one that's got an ankle wrist facing down. And you have a pair of open hands. You do have to switch the hand covers, which I never really like, but it's not a huge deal. It's just a slight inconvenience. But of course, this guy, because he's very basic, comes with his own accessories, his own weapons and armor. And it's all white, which is a nice contrast to the darker color scheme that it has. And it's very, very easy to put on. A lot of them are all just tabs, but these, like, round pegs, but these ones here on the knees are specifically, tabbed. Like, some of the other ones you can kind of, like, switch, because they're just the round holes, but not the knee armor. And just a few more pieces. Now, there are some of the, pieces you have to swap out for the shoulders. Because the shoulder armor, in order to put it on, you have to take this part of the shoulder and replace it with, if I can find it, there it is. This one, which has a slightly longer stem, which will accept the actual shoulder armor. So you can kind of see the difference there. So, not a huge deal, because if you're not going to ever take the armor off, you just never have to swap the shoulders. And it's not, I don't feel it's that big of a difference. It's a little, makes the shoulders a little longer, but I don't think it's that big of a deal. Like, I could totally leave it on or not. And I do kind of like the fact that the shoulder armor is asymmetrical. And then finally, we have the faceplate, which is very nice looking. And there we go. There he is with his ninja type armor. Looking very good. Really do like the white. And it doesn't hinder the articulation really. The shoulder armor is on a hinge. So you can still utilize the articulation there. And nothing's really getting in the way. So yeah, whatever articulation it had before, I'm pretty sure it has exactly the same. And it does have some accessories for weapons. You got this cool-looking gun, which goes nicely into the hand, but this is kind of where you'd want to have the angled hand, just so it's a little more straight. It doesn't really matter, but it helps more with this one. And you can holster it on the model. You have this very simple connector, which can go on either of the hips, and then you can just peg it in there, and it can hinge up and down to get out of the way. And then finally, you have two, I guess they're daggers, which are nicely detailed, and you can have them in the hands. Of course, you can have them straight or under, and they do have some tabs on the side, so if you want, you can always peg them together, like that, or something I kind of like, you can peg them on the gun to kind of give it a bayonet. So that's kind of cool. And of course, you can store it on the model. It does have these different points. You can peg them on the back, or you can use the little ones that are sticking out on the back skirt. And you just store them on there. So if you don't want to have the model holding any of the accessories, they can all be mount it on the model. So yeah, that's pretty much it. It does have, I think, quite a bit of stuff for just a basic model. I guess because it's so thin, they were allowed to give it some more stuff. And I think it was very good. So we'll compare it. Yeah, he does have little feet, but he still stands. We'll use a Gundam, the entry grade. A little taller. And then we'll compare him with the other two that I have, which I've already forgotten their names. Oh yeah, he's definitely a tall boy. He's thin, but he's tall. So that is the Spinatio Ninja type. It's pretty nice. I really like it. I do have an add-on kit for this guy. It is the first one I've ever gotten for the 30-minute mission. So it'll be nice to see what it does to him. Definitely a cool model to get. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.